Hello and welcome to Dixie 5 Tips and Tricks. My name is Klaus Wagner, and in this video I would like to show you how to set up a parallel voltage control for 3 transformers. Let's first prepare the configuration for one transformer and then copy-paste and adapt it for the other two transformers. With Ciprotec 5, one dedicated device for every transformer is required in parallel operation. The voltage control function can be configured in almost all Ciprotec 5 devices. Not only in the 7UT8, and the device types for parallel control can be mixed if necessary. So that, for example, a 7UT85 works together with two 7SJ85. Maybe not a very practical example, but it's possible. We start with a 7UT87 configuration, which has no inconsistencies for a standalone two-winding voltage controller. The parallel operation is possible only with a function group type for two-winding transformers. However, three-winding transformers, where always the same winding should be controlled, can also be put in parallel. In this case, the function group for two-winding transformers is suitable. The communication between the various voltage regulators is done between the devices via IC61850 protocol. Therefore, the first step is to activate the protocol on an Ethernet interface. We go to Hardware and Protocols, and I use the port J, so I mark the port J. And here under Protocols, we see 61850 is already selected, and it makes sense also to adjust here the IP address right from the beginning if I have another range of addresses than the normal one. I leave it here with the standard IP addresses. Parallel transformer control works only with IC61850 edition 2. So let's switch right from the beginning to edition 2 in the device information editor. Here we see the edition and it's already set to edition 2. Then let's go to the device settings. Device settings, the general settings here. Here we need to show all Ciprotec extensions because some of them are required for the parallel voltage regulation. It is this setting here, and we have absolutely to set it to show all Ciprotec extensions. Further down, under Activate Device Functionality, if you use the port J as we do here, then ensure that you select Inclusive Goose, otherwise it will not work. The communication between the Ciprotec devices is handled via so-called proxies. Every device needs a proxy for every other device it should communicate with. In our example, with 3 transformers in total, every device communicates with 2 other devices. So in every device, we need to configure 2 proxies. The proxies can be found in the function 90V parallel operation, which we drag and drop from the library onto the function group for voltage control. When we open the settings of the 90V parallel operation function, we see that there is already one instance of the proxies. So we need to add just one more, clicking on Add New Stage. So that's it for the preparation. Now we triple our device and then set the IP addresses of the 2 new devices. So here are the 3 devices. I meanwhile copy the devices and rename them. And what is left is, as I said before, to adapt the IP address of every device in the port J properties. So here I take the 61 of the second device, and I can also jump here to the 3rd device. And in the properties, I set the 62. So every of the 3 devices now here has a unique IP address. In the next part of this topic, I will show you how to automatically assign the necessary signals and measurements for parallel operation. I hope you like this video. Thank you for watching and goodbye.
Siemens, ingenuity for life.